Tonight, we continue our extensive Commitment 2010 coverage, providing you, the Action 7 News viewer, with the information you need to make an informed decision when you enter the voting booth November 2nd. The focus tonight is on the two men who want to be sheriff of the state's most populated county, Bernalillo. We asked the candidates 8 questions and gave each of them 90 seconds to answer, and you will hear their entire response. This question asks, with recent concern over training deficiencies with some deputies, talk about your plan to train and make all deputies current.
The deficiencies were identified through internally. Our plan is to, we already had a plan in place, and we started that a month ago. There's a master schedule out right now to get all the deputies trained up for 2010-2011. And then if there's any discrepancies in the 2008-2009 maintenance training that they need, we'll go ahead and fulfill that training also, which will make us current. We are fully certified and recognized by the state. And there's no deficiencies because as of right now, they've performed no audits. The audits are being conducted by ourselves, and we're taking that proactive step in order to get our officers up to speed in case there's any question from the previous biannual training in 2008-2009.
I've been affiliated, I said, with Albuquerque Police Department since 2006. They have a very efficient program. I just completed my second 8 hours of this year with their agency last week. I've been doing the maintenance training with them for the last 4 years. They have a very unique procedure. They do 2 8-hour classes and then a 4-hour classroom instruction prior to firearms qualifications. And it's a very similar program that I will work with them. I have talked to the people out at the Albuquerque Police Academy. I know that they're very willing to work with us in helping us sustain and maintain our certification and us even work together to offer assistance to them too. So I believe that this is a very fixable thing. I'm not sure how the ball got dropped, but we'll certainly get on top of it. We'll maintain it, and we'll make sure that the deputies are always in compliance with the minimum level of 40 hours every 2-year period.
At tonight 6, we're going to ask the candidates, what is the deputy count right now and what is needed to adequately patrol the county? Their answers at 6. And remember, the general election is November 2nd.